you doing? How you doing? Alcoholic.
Is it lying?
Thank you.
We had two vacant dwellings, both going.
You had problems.
We had problems with a bad hydrant to begin with. Companies had to backstretch to another hydrant. The next engine in had monitor problems. And that was the extent of it pretty well.
It almost spread to this building.
Almost, but we did keep it away. We kept it away from the other dwelling.
What type of hose lines and equipment have you got in here for this?
Well, we've probably got about five 2.5s and 4 1.5s, plus we had a monitor and a tower going.
We came from our command post. Everybody's designated command post tonight.
So you actually will centralize your efforts from a command?
Right. And then what they do is move companies up the line.
Is that just done on this Devil's Night situation?
Yeah, right. Devil's Night or any civil disturbances they have, you know.
Does that leave some houses unmanned?
No. Generally, they're all manned. All the engine houses are manned. In fact, they got extra companies tonight. They got like about 17 extra companies.
What does the average Detroit firefighter think about this time of the year?
It's dreadful. Because we're working a 24-hour period. We'll be working until like 8 o'clock in the morning. You know, hopefully, the way the city's been going and stuff like that with their extra effort and that to subside this, it might work out. It might not be as busy as it was like in 84 and 85.
So this is quite a citywide effort to try to keep this down, isn't it?
Yeah, with the citizens, the administration, the fire department, police department, everybody.
No other city in the country has anything quite like this.
Not to my knowledge.
What do you think brings it on?
Well, for one thing, there's a lot of abandoned houses in the city and everything like that. It's more or less a tradition, I guess. This is, as long as I've been on a job. I've been on a job for 14 years. This has been going on just about every year that I've been on. It's gotten worse within, like I said, like from, from 83 on up to the present date. You know, it's been getting worse, but now she's starting to decline a little bit.
Give me an idea of what your shift is like. I mean, you know a year in advance that you're going to be working this type
of... Oh, yeah, with our schedules and that, we could determine it.
Thank you. David Eberhard,
City Council in Detroit.
What do you attribute the apparent diminution of fire activity on this Devil's Night?
I think it's a combination of the curfew that has been issued from 6 p.m. to 6 a.m. upon the young people of the city, which I think causes for more celebration than devastation. I think it's also the mobilization of the many people involved in the police reserves and the citizens patrols. I've been out tonight with the citizen patrols. We have over 500 cars of citizens on the street helping to watch, and I think all of that collectively together with the whole effort of the city saying, you know, enough's enough. We've had it. We don't need any more devastation. And so far tonight, it's been very, very successful.
What type of pre-planning was there as opposed to last year? In other words, what did you do for this Devil's Night that you didn't do in prior years?
I think the mayor took a much tougher stand for one thing. I think also there are many community groups and meetings that were involved for many, many months telling people no more devil in Devil's Night. And I think it caught on because the neighborhoods said, we've had enough of this. And I think it took a very tough stand by the mayor and a very firm stand that he's not going to put up with it. And I think the message got out last night with the arrest of over 290 individuals brought into the downtown that we mean business. We don't need any more of this.
It would appear then with the arrests of last night, or at least the stop, that most of the fire activity was started by youngsters under 18. I mean, just logically at this point.
I'm not about to make that type of a comment because I don't know for sure. But I think it did help to hold it down. I've been throughout the city entire night. We've had maybe 3 or 4 fires, which is not unusual for just a regular night.
The Detroit Fire Department had tremendous pressure put on it, more so than most departments ever could expect, did they not?
And they have held up very well. Our firemen do a very good job. You can see from the tremendous amount of show of power that they have that they're doing a fine job. Thank you.
is up here. Oh, it is 26. Okay, so we're going to have to put the truck over here. Over here, and then you can stretch here. Oh, okay. So we're going to have to...
Rolf, R-O-L-F, Roberts.
And battalion chief.
Yes, I am.
Mm-hmm. Chief, it appears that the so-called Devil's Night has been tremendously diluted over past years. What reasons do you give for that?
The reasons, probably the paramount reason, is because of the mayor looking into the situation and putting forth the enforcement he did of the curfew. This is one thing that was very noticeable on the streets in my particular battalion tonight, was the absence of youngsters roaming the streets.
How do you gear up your people for something that in past years has been as concentrated and potentially stressful as this 24 to 48 hour period? How do you psych them up mentally? Are there any tricks? And what do you tell them?
No, there's no tricks. This probably goes back to the basic training of a firefighter in Detroit through the Fire Academy, where just coming on duty in the morning, the esprit de corps, the challenge that's going to confront them during their tour of duty. This all works in conjunction with whatever happens during the course of the tour.